How and why China is building islands in the South China Sea. What would you say if I asked if you wanted to own your own private island in the South China Sea? Yes, you heard right. A private island. Just for yourself. Well, and probably the Chinese government. This Asian country has been building man-made bases over a number of the Spratly Islands in the South China Sea since 2014, much to the annoyance of other powers in the region. The Philippines, Malaysia, Vietnam, and Japan all claim parts of the ocean, which is a valuable trade route and fishing ground. Wondering about China's artificial islands and why they're so important? Well, for those wondering what a man-made island is made of, the answer is pretty simple. The same thing most islands are made of. Sand. It seems China's island-building plan sits on a contentious intersection of technology, politics, and the environment. To construct its artificial islands, China builds on top of already existing islands, rocks, and even coral reefs. To collect all of these, China uses a fleet of dredgers, ships designed to select and move materials up from the sea floor. Once the islands are large and stable enough, China can then lay down cement and build structures on them. The extent of the changes are often striking. In 2014, China claimed they were developing the islands for navigational purposes. What else would they say, right? A number of the islands do have lighthouses to ease ships through, but several are now evidently military bases. Although the position of the islands may have navigational benefits, Alessio Patalano, senior lecturer in Asian Security and War Studies at King's College London, says that China's choice of location reveals more about their aims on other fronts. Although China keeps denying it's militarizing the islands it's built, Beijing can now deploy military assets, including combat aircraft and mobile missile launchers, to the Spratly Islands at any time, said the Asia Maritime Transparency Initiative, AMTI, on Monday during a report that included images of the three man-made islands, Fiery Cross Reef, Subi, and Mischief. Its director, Greg Poling, told Voice of America that new antennas have been spotted on Subi and Fiery Cross, so he expected deployments there soon. Now, if I ask you again about building a private island in this ocean, you might think twice, wouldn't you? But the real question is, why did China build these islands? And why did they manage to form land out of the sea? Building a military base on a reef would guarantee China coverage from the entire of the South China Sea in terms of radio and military range. China's island-building efforts require an important investment in engineering and infrastructure. So why is the country getting into all this trouble? Perhaps the prime motivation is to strengthen China's claim over the region. The Spratly Islands and other nearby chains lack indigenous populations. As such, they're claimed by a variety of neighboring nations. Vietnam, the Philippines, Malaysia, and China all claim portions of the South China Sea. But China's claim is extraordinary. This area is as important to China as tweeting is to Donald Trump. The South China Sea is amongst one of the busiest trade routes in the world. Consistent with information gathered by the Council on Foreign Relations, at least $5.3 trillion worth of shipping travels through the ocean each year. $1.2 trillion of this trade belongs to the US. Beyond its importance as a trade route, the South China Sea also contains bountiful resources beneath the surface. The US Energy Information Administration, EIA, estimates that there are 11 billion barrels of oil in the South China Sea, as well as 190 trillion cubic feet of gas. As East Asia continues to grow in importance, these resources, and who gets to regulate them, will become more important. But what about the environment? What's the ecological impact of building these islands? Coral reefs are delicate ecosystems made from thousands of varied creatures, and therefore the sand piled on top of the reefs smothers these organisms. This is often troubling because although reefs occupy a small fraction of the world's oceans, they're among the most populous marine areas, supporting thousands of varied species, The damage doesn't stop at the reefs either. The sand will kill nearly any bottom-dwelling organisms on which it settles in large quantities and clog the gills of most fish, Professor John McManus said to The Guardian. As a result, thousands of species within the sea might be destroyed. And this might have consequences beyond the ecological. Coral reefs are, amazingly enough, important to the development of pharmaceuticals. But it seems that China does not care. And in recent months, current imagery shows that China has likely started building airstrips on long, straight sections of every one of these islands, which would give the country 3 airstrips in this area. For now, the synthetic islands remain a grey harbinger of an uncertain future.